So what is the business practice that has the most impact in this flowing of automating business processes? Well, it's business analysis and therefore as well, any business automation. What is business analysis? Here I would like to stress out a point that business analysis is like a spectrum that has two sort of like edges. It lives in between what is would be the strategic analysis, that is the C-level, the C-suite, which is concerned to how to arrange business processes and how to enact a digital transformation program in order to maybe improve some of the processes that the business is doing today, or as well to unlock a new business opportunity, new opportunities that might lie in the market that the business would like to offer a service or offer a product for. And this is on one end. On the other hand, you would have IT analysis. This is maybe also more known to the audience as well. This is about translating what is typically discussed as a business requirement or functional requirement and to translate it into actual hardware or software needed to support this. So the business analysis is everything that is in this spectrum that facilitate the elicitation of business requirement and everything that is needed from a process analysis, from a modeling analysis, in order to translate what is really the strategy of the business into an actual executable things in software and in hardware where needed. What will be the challenges that are facing? Those are always evolving. So there is always changing in policies inside the business or coming from external events such as a new regulation. Think about in Europe, the GDPR legislation and how it's impacted many businesses. There is also another key challenge, which is the increasing amount of events from various sources that you would like to integrate and to take advantage of from a business point of view. So a few years ago, really big data was such a buzzword. And think about at that time how much we talked about the variety of data. Has this disappeared? No. It is always an increasing concern or an opportunity that we might like to leverage. And so all of this is about defining really what is your processes and how you want to automate it and how do you want to really consolidate all the strategy into an executable thing. And here is where business automation can help. And we will see how we do it as well whenever possible with open standards. So with business automation, we are interested in offering you a process definition. This is known from BPMN, for instance, or decision paradigms, such as what I have represented here, a decision table, which is not only but a visual way to represent how you make a decision based on certain constraint. It can be a decision. It can also be known as a rule. So maybe something that is more known in the CEP scenarios that is really a DSL to describe that under a certain constraint, you would have some consequence executed out of that. And then, of course, part of this is as well everything about mathematical optimizations. Think about every optaplanner use cases that you may have seen in this on this channel with Geoffrey, like vehicle routing. So that is also taking that into account, like in a constraint optimization problem, how we can take the best decision that really have the most impactful outcome in improving a process or a service that you would like to provide.